Let me move this fan here. There we go. Hello, everybody.
You're over there.
Okay. Anyway, hope you guys are doing good. And it's January already. This month's flying by, even though it's a long month.
I got a haircut.
I needed a haircut. And Lala dyed my hair. She's so good. She's here this time. Last time she wasn't here. Time before, I forgot to set her mic up. So she's here. And ask some questions. Don't forget to make the face. See, steady. Steady. It's got to be steady. So anyway, what's going on? It's been really cold here. We're in California near San Diego. And it's been cold. It's in the 40s at night. For us, that's cold. You guys on the East Coast, you're laughing, right? And a lot of rain. But it stopped. I love that. That's all the right hand stuff. Right hand with the foot. Showed you this before. Maybe you weren't paying attention. But that's a simple one. That's right, left, left, right, left. Whatever you do with your right hand. Put the bass drum with the right hand. Those are doubles. Right, right, left, left, right, right. So you got right, left, left, right, left, left, right. Double. Right, right, left, left, right. Singles even will work too, like this. Put them together. You got singles. Then the next one, the triplet. Right, left, left. Double. Put them all together. The fill. Stuff, but that's all it is. It's the right hand with the bass drum. If you're lefty, it could be the left hand with the bass drum. And so that's a simple exercise. But with all exercises, you got to start slow. You know, when I teach something, I don't want you to go fast. Get messed up. And then it gets messed up. You're better off going slow, steady. Okay. Get louder. Practice actually to get a lick, whatever you're doing, and just go as fast as you can and then slow it down, you know, like this. I mean, in the 80s, this was big, the triplet. Left, right foot, left, right foot. Right. To end a solo. Hopefully had some pyro right there. But that's the way a lot of solos ended, you know. You get fast and then you just do the big build up at the end. So we had a little trouble here. Of course, right before I went on, we had an audio issue and an account issue on Facebook. I don't know what happened. And we had to fix it, but I noticed that we're lacking some people here and there. So, but the sound is good and everything else is good. We're going to work on it later and see what happened. But that stuff always happens when you go right before you go on. You know, even live, it's like maybe the intro tape starts playing, you're ready to go on, and you tie your shoe, right? Tie it, all of a sudden it doesn't tie right. Oh, let me do it again. And then there's a knot. And now you got to try to get the knot out and retie it before the show starts. Sometimes you don't make it and just go on with that, you know. Okay. So what's the other thing I was going to say? Oh, yeah. So somebody texted me, I realize this, I should realize it, that this year is going to be 40 years of Holy Diver. And it's pretty amazing that Holy Diver, the first Dio record we made, became such a classic album, you know, and a cornerstone of a lot of the rock stuff. We didn't know. We were just making a good album and having fun doing it, you know. We didn't know this would be such a great album. And I'm not saying it's great. Everybody tells me it's pretty good. I don't want to sound egotistical. Something that came out, and so it's 40 years, and so we're going to do some dates. We had a video that just came out called Ghost Town with Last in Line that came out on Friday. Check it out, and that's on YouTube. It's called Ghost Town, Ghost Town, Ghost Town, and it doesn't sound like it. That's not it. So that's out, and we got an album coming out March 30th. To match that. Really good album. It's really cool. And we had fun doing it. So let's see what happens. And so we got some dates at the end of March and some in April. And then May, Def Leppard gets busy in the summer. They're doing a tour in Europe. So we lose Vivian, our guitar player. So I'm putting together, I did this before, but I'm putting together I do a tribute, not a tribute, it's a Sabbath band. Did it in Europe, how many times? About 3 or 4 times, like 25 shows. It's a great, great band we put together, and we play all this, like, Mob Rule stuff that I'm on, some old Sabbath that I'm not on, and some Dio. And people love it, you know? I mean, it was a trip. I played some places in Europe, like Slovakia and Czech, and, you know, little villages. And we pull up in the afternoon, I go, who's going to come to this heavy kind of show, you know? It's like streets are deserted and there's nobody around. And then when it comes showtime, the place fills up. And they love it, you know? Well, they love the fact that you actually came to them to play. It's so remote and so remote. So these people love it, and it's such nice people, and we have a great time. So I did a bunch of those, and then I did it in South America. So in the summer, I'm going to be doing some more of that. I'm going to be doing some dates, hopefully in California and hopefully on the East Coast and all around Ohio again. I play with my buddy Mike Carr, in the Ohio area, and it's a great show. It's a cool show. It's playing all that stuff again. And for me, it's fun, you know. It's fun. It's like low pressure. You know, last in line is pressure, baby. Got to play it, you know. This is, you know, fun, more fun. They're both fun, obviously, but this is just low stress, and it's a fun time. So I'll keep you posted. It'll be on my website when I get some dates going and all that stuff. And I'm looking forward to that. And also, I'll be doing these live streams as we go along. This is live stream number 104. Is it 104? First was the 3rd, the 7th, the 10th, the 17th. This is the 5th. Hi, Lala.
Hi.
Yeah. So you notice a lot of stuff I'm playing on these. This is the sawtooth kit. This is the hickory kit. 6 plies of pure hickory. I want you to know what I'm playing if you like the sound. A nice tone on these drums. And this is going through all this stuff over here and going to Facebook and going to the telephone poles outside and the wires all the way to your home for your enjoyment. So this is a 6-ply hickory, great, and no filler wood, nothing like that. And we got solid steel lugs, die-cast hoops, and all the wing nuts are oversized. Really cool kit. I love this kit. And this is 10, 12, 13, 14, 16, 18. And the snare, this is a 6.5. And love these drums. The bass drums are 14 by 24. 14 is like from the 60s. People use 14s. And the thing with the 14 is fast. The air moves quicker. Anyway, that's the drums I'm using. The heads are G27s, Sabian cymbals, double A, very loud cymbals, 14 hi-hats. That's a 16, that's an 18, 20. Oh, no, sorry, 18, 20 inch wide. And so some of the stuff I'm playing, you know, is with the hi-hat, right? My hi-hat doesn't always play so steady like this. Actually, even if you hear that hi-hat, I'm not playing it. It's got some feel in it, the accents on the quarter notes there. But I'm not playing. That's kind of stiff. You play just this, people get it. See, what I do is I'm breaking it up. I'm hanging. That kind of stuff there, 16th notes. That's a cool little fill, too, if you're playing. So it's left, right, right. Bass drum. So something to keep in mind. And a lot of the great players like Bonham, my brother, that didn't play like this. So stiff. Different ways to approach it. So keep it in mind. Good way to practice. Play the eighth notes like this. Go to quarters. And the lick I just showed you. Yeah. And you got to play with dynamics. So I'm playing a lot of stuff low. This way, what I was doing now is just playing quieter and then filling a little bit of filling, but it was loud. Then I come back down. So that was a dynamic, soft and loud. Okay, so Lala's in the house.
Hello. Yes, I'm here this week.
She's alive.
I am.
Got a good haircut today.
I did.
It's like haircut week.
It's been haircut week.
Say, so what do we got for questions here?
What do we have for questions?
Yes.
Why don't you use sticks that have both the butt ends on them instead of?
That's what my brother has. He has a stick that has. Look at this stick. It's wearing out. And it feels good, so keep using it. You know what? I got used to just turning the stick around, so I play with the butt end. And that leaves me, what I'm used to is the room, it leaves me on this end. There's a lot of space for your hands. So I'm just used to playing like this, too. You know? And I was looking at pictures that I had, some old pictures, and back when I was a kid, I was playing like this. I don't know why. So anyway, that's why I don't do that. But you know who could probably play that way is this guy. Look at this guy.
Oh, turn it around.
You don't recognize him this way. But if you go this way, who is that? What's his name in the...
Thing.
Thing, that's right. Thing. In Adam's Family. Makes a good muffler. This is for Jace. This was made on the 3D printer.
On Thing.
Thing. This is Thing. Wild Thing. Put a stick in there. There's Thing. I didn't make this. We had a visitor. Leslie's daughter and a boyfriend. He's an electronic whiz. Works for Tesla. He's amazing. He figured out the whole thing. Next thing you know, this thing printed. This took about 12 hours or 15 hours to make this. I made one dog. Little dog, it's terrible. Made the dog. Doesn't even look right, but it's a dog. You can tell it's a dog somewhat. And then I said, okay, let's make the cat, you know. So I went to make the cat. Didn't come out good. It came out like a pancake. Oh, okay, so I made a pancake. So I let me try it another time. I did it, pancake again. So I did like three pancakes and one dog. He comes over and he makes this thing. He made a little rocket ship. It was like incredible. That's for you, Jace. You know what I mean. That's a cool feel, too. I think that's in one of the Zep songs, too. Good. Practice all different feels instead of just playing 4/4. These are like quarter notes. That's all it is. You put two snares on the second hi-hat hit. You got bass drum, say, bass drum, snare. Two eighth notes. All right? Then you put in the grace notes. Grace notes are all these notes you hear that are low. Like that one. And the grace note is played softly. Good to play all these different feels, you know, things like that, and you know, fast. Okay, you got another question?
How did Last in Line record the album? Were you guys all together? Was it individual overdubs? How'd that work?
Well, Last in Line, we record all together. We rehearse together and write the songs together. We go in a room. And this is the way it's been done with Sabbath. When we wrote the Mob Rules, we went into a rehearsal room. And I don't really think my drums were there. I don't know. They could have been there. We might have blocked the room, so my drums were there. But we get in the room, and we start jamming and playing with Tony Iommi. He's like the riff master, obviously. And we start jamming on things, and then, that's cool. Record it. Boom. We had cassette players that back then, cassette recorders. And then we'd embellish from there and pick it up the next day and work with that riff and come up with everything. So we recorded like that as well. We're in the studio, and I forgot, Tony and Geezer, I think, were in the control room. Ronnie was out in the vocal booth, and we'd run the song down to record it. But we'd do it together, you know? And that's the way we did all the Sabbath stuff. And then when we formed Dio, we did the same thing. We're in the room, we wrote together, and we recorded together. Everything was together. So Last in Line, we did the same thing. The only thing that was done differently was the song, the Beatles song we did, A Day in the Life. That one was done in each of our studios at home. And what I did was I put up the song and just to get the structure, and I played to the Beatles song. And then where the fast part comes in, the Beatles didn't do that riff there, so I just played to the riff. I had a click. Played enough bars for the lick and then came back and then inserted the Beatles again, played to it, you know. So that's the only track we ever did and we weren't in the same room. But everything else, the new album, we actually went to Danny Gorka from Counting Cars. He's got a great studio in Vegas and we've been rehearsing there for a number of times, like 3 days, 4 days at a time. We wrote a lot of our stuff for the second album there and most of the stuff for this album. And then we used his studio to record. So check out the sounds. And we, of course, had Chris Collier mixing it, who's just amazing with sounds, especially drums. Everything sounds loud, which is cool. It's loud! So That's the way we record. That's a good question. And this reminds me of Heaven and Hell. Song Heaven and Hell. You go, sing me a song. I played it like this back then. And then lately I'm playing it. Some of them. I changed it up. I think Bill played it like this. More of this. But I went to that, and especially on the second half of the first. Build it up more rather than being. Not quite the same feel. This. Yeah. So, got changed along the way. Okay, next question.
How do you memorize a song and remember all the parts?
I know, that's why I make a lot of mistakes. I made mistakes today. You know, I put these things on, I listen to them, and there's a couple of, usually in all these songs I played on, the first one was Kill Devil Hill with Rex Brown, me, and Dewey and Mark. And the second one is a, I don't know if we used that song, it was a demo for maybe the album we did with together with Carmine. And I, and that was Craig Goldie on guitar and on bass. And some of them, you know, it's like, okay, let's stop and count one and a half, then do that riff, boom, and that's usually my idea. And then it comes back to bite me later on because, oh, wait a minute, I got to figure that out. Where's it coming in? One, two, three, you know, wherever the hell it's coming in. And a prime example of that is the song Last in Line. The beginning, the Dio song Last in Line, da, 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 the quiet part. First one's got four clicks. So the first one. One, two, three. Da, 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 right? Second one is five. That's why I open the hi-hat. On the fifth one, make sure that everybody knows that's it. So that's come back, you know, it's like, oh, this is five. Comes back to bite me, you know, make sure it's five and not four. I've seen bands play where it's four. But what the heck. So those things are usually my doings. And then I go, that must have been me. And I remember, you know, I usually would write out, listen to the song, write out block charts, like, you know, intro, guitar, two bars, band, two bars, verse, pre-chorus, chorus, verse, or intro. Do it like that while I'm listening to it a couple times, and that gets you familiar with the song. And then just, I do that, and I listen to the song, you know, and I get into the song. And just play along with it until it feels natural. Now, I must say I cheat when I'm in the studio here when I do songs. You know, I do sessions here. I get the song. I never heard the song before. So I listen to it, and then usually the first take, I'll go crazy, play everything, you know. It's all this crazy stuff. And then I'll listen back. I go, you know what? That's good. I'm going to leave that. But I don't like the beginning, so I'm going to fix that, and then I'll do that much. Yeah, that's cool. And then listen to the rest of it and punch it in and out. But a good way to do it is to just go crazy. I know guys do opposite that. They play the whole song, and then they listen and go, well, maybe it needs this. I do the opposite. I go play it crazy like Keith Moon would play it, and then I pick out stuff I like, and I leave it, and then fix it around there. And then sometimes it takes, like, there's a hang, like... a one bar break, and sometimes it just doesn't fit. Just going, and that doesn't fit in there. Believe it or not, what about? Well, what about, you know? Well, how about this? All right, that one. I'm kidding, but just the simple fill. Sometimes that works. Two, three. Back to the verse. But it's really weird when you're recording. That's just because it's a fill and it fits the timing. Sometimes the fills don't sound good. So you do, you know, try. I try all different fills. It could be a half an hour and just that. Crazy. When I could be in the kitchen eating something. But
having some dinner.
Dinner! Yeah! Okay, another question.
Show your grip close up.
Here's my grip, baby. Like that. It's just match grip. I don't play like this anymore. I used to play like that. And that's like a stress reliever. You're playing like this. You go, you know, I'm getting a little, it's a little tight. You know, with the first gig. So I'll switch over to this. It's not good, you know, you're bending your finger and hitting the bone this way. This way you're hitting down. There's nothing there to get destroyed. You know, it's a pivot. This one is like you're hitting it and you're left to right, and it's hitting your bone. So I started having I pinched it one time. I was just sitting there twirling the stick, and all of a sudden went, ow, and it hurt. So ever since then, I stopped playing that way. I'll occasionally do it quickly and then come back. Yeah. How about one more question?
We have a comment here. It takes 2 minutes and 30 seconds on average for you to answer a question.
What does that mean?
I don't know. Somebody's timing how long every time I answer a question, how long.
Do you mean my answer's 2 minutes and 30 seconds?
That's what somebody commented. They must be paying attention.
Okay, ask me another question. I won't take so long. What's another question?
Do you have any Canada dates planned with Last in Line?
No.
Not yet? No.
How long did that take?
1 minute. 1 second.
Not 1 minute. No, that was 2 seconds.
Why do drummers have multiple snares?
Because they can.
All around the kit. Are they different?
Because they can.
Because they can?
I'm answering them real quick.
Now you're answering fast.
Multiple snares, I don't know. You know, usually you have, I don't have multiple snares. Usually they would put a snare over here on the left side of the hi-hat. Tuned very high, so you got different accents. You know, usually on the ends. More of a percussion kind of thing, too. I tried that. I didn't like it. So I'd rather stay on a snare. All right. So thank you for joining me and Lala. We're going to figure out what to eat tonight. We're not going to go out.
No.
I saw a bunch of potatoes in the closet, fresh potatoes. So we'll eat some potatoes and something else.
Don't forget, you can order stuff online and have it signed by Vinny on Thursday.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Let me mention it. I'm not doing the Heavy Metal Hall of Fame. It got to be too confusing. And originally, I was supposed to induct Sebastian Bach into the Hall of Fame. Well, he's not showing up. He lives in Vegas. He's not going to come over here to the Valley for this. I kind of thought that anyway. I know him pretty well. And I'm not doing that. And then it was talk of playing with Lou Gramm one song. And I'm not doing that because I can't bring anybody with me. I can't even bring Lala.
And I want to
bring my drum company, Joe Fuco, and his wife. And so it's like 2 weeks ago, it was fine. Give me a guest list. Now it's like, it was sold out. I was like, all right, forget about it. It's going to be crazy. So instead, I'm going up to the GoDPS headquarters. And Rudy Sauzer and I, we're going to be signing stuff. So whatever you buy, between now and tomorrow or tomorrow night, whatever, we'll sign it for you. I signed a whole bunch of guitars at Christmas time that people bought and wanted me to sign them. So whatever you buy, I'll sign them. You buy a snare drum, you buy, guitars, bass, whatever.
Yeah, there's a code for product off, too. There's a code here for
product. There's a code for product off. What is it?
30% off select products.
What?
30% off select products, and there's a link there.
What?
Stop it. Kitty. Oh, my gosh. And then just, tell them what you want signed in the notes, like what you want it to say.
Yeah.
If you want it personalized.
Back in the 80s, we used to sign things, you know. It wasn't, you know. So girls would come up and go, hey, sign my breast, let's say, breast. And I'd look, I go, oh, she looks a bit young. So I'd sign Carmine's autograph on there. This way, she went home. Her dad would go, who signed your boobies? Who's this Carmine Appice? See? Okay. Anyway. Okay, so that's tomorrow. We're doing it tomorrow. No, tomorrow's Wednesday.
Thursday.
So we're doing it Thursday. So between now and Thursday, check it out online. You get 30% off, and we'll sign stuff. Rita, you'll sign basses and drums or whatever you got. We'll sign it, you know. So even sticks. If he sells sticks, I think he does. Cases, we got great cases. I've been using these cases. How many years now? 6 years. And I still got the original cases. They haven't ripped. They haven't fallen apart. So check out the stuff online. Get the 30% off. So anything else, Lala?
I think that's it with that one.
And I won't be at the Heavy Metal Hall of Fame. So if anybody's going, have fun and bring your earplugs because it's heavy metal. All right. Thanks for joining me. I'll be back next week. And be safe.